Good morning, students. Today we'll start with History, Standard 6, Chapter 2, The Egyptian Civilization. Before going through this slide, let me just recall that we all have done the sources, origin, periods, social classes, and life of the people of the Egyptian civilization. Now we are going to deal with religion. The Egyptians worshipped many gods and goddesses, and their main god was Amun, Re, or Ra, which is the sun god. In the third point, children, we can see now what does the sun gives us. Of course, it is the source of light and warmth, so it is regarded as the king of all gods. And Thoth, that is the moon god, was represented by Ibis, which is a water bird. Thoth was one of the most important gods of ancient Egypt, alternative said to be self-created or born of the seed of Horus, you can say. So he had an picture, that is, you can see in the picture also, he has a head of a bird and human body. So he was born on his own. Then comes Horus. Now Horus is it's a sky bird, was often the ancient Egyptians you can say a national tutelary deity. They used to worship him, and he was usually depicted as falcon headed man. Falcon headed is falcon is a hawk only, wearing a. In religion, this part also comes, children, that is, the Egyptian believed in life after death. That's why what they used to do, they used to preserve the dead body of that person, which is also known as mummifying their bodies. How they used to mummify? They used to cover the dead body with herbs and spices and then wrapped it in fine linen, so that their body can be preserved for a long period of time, which is also known as mummy, which we say, which is a very famous term in history, mummies. And here the Egyptian, what they used to do, they used to pack it and enclose it in a wooden box, in a stone coffin, you can say, in a box, wooden box. And a coffin is there in which they put it, and then they bury it inside a tomb. And do you know, children, that many things were put into that tomb and it was buried with them only. Why? Because they thought that these everyday needs, these things, everyday things that they were put inside, so that they may use them after life. As they believed that death is a temporary phase between life and the next part, that is next part of his life or her life. So this, that is why the famous pyramids are also there. Looking into this slide, we get to know the occupation of the Egyptian people. So people were mainly engaged in agriculture, which was gifted by the Nile. I have already explained that it was the gift of the Nile to Egypt, for which the plains were fertile and the farmers were enabled to grow crops. So by this point we can get to know that this was the major occupation of the Egyptian, that is agriculture. After that, many more were there, like pottery making, spinning, weaving glass, then weaving glass making, carpentry, poultry farming, fishing. These were some of the occupations followed by the. This is the pottery which was used in ancient Egypt. What do we mean by trade and commerce? In this slide, we'll understand the buying and selling of goods is known as trade and commerce. And trade was an important activity. Goods were transported over land. How? With the usage of camels and donkeys. Now here we can see they used animals for their transportation. Export items were also there which they used to export. That is, the main items of export were linen, jewelry and glassware, the things made of glass. But what were the major import items? Import means which we get from or bring from another country, which we import them. So the major import items were gold, ivory, oil and in this slide you can have a look at the dead body, that is how they used to mummify the bodies. They used to cover the dead body with herbs and spices and then wrap it in a fine linen, and they used to let us look into some of the major achievements. So one of it is in the field of architecture, that is the Egyptian, they were great builders. So what they constructed many pyramids and temples. In the second point we can see the Great Pyramid is the largest pyramid in Giza. Giza is a city in Egypt and it is situated in the west bank of River Nile. Situated on the west bank of River Nile, and it was built by Pharaoh Cheops, and it was the tomb of King Khufu. It is also regarded as one of the seven wonders of the ancient world. Now another architectural wonder is Sphinx, which is a mythological figure, means there is a story behind it for its belief. Now what is Sphinx? Sphinx is actually it is a structure with the head of a man and a body of a lion, and that was carved out of a single block of stone. Different stones were not taken to carve for the carving of this Sphinx. Only single block of stone was there to carve it out. This is how the Great Pyramid looks. So the Great Pyramid at Giza, which was built by Pharaoh Cheops. In this slide, children, you can see another architectural wonder, that is the Sphinx, which is a mythological figure, and it has a head of a man, you can see, and the body is of a lion, and the stone with which it is carved out is single block. Now we'll study the major achievement of the Egyptians in mathematics. They had made a great progress in mathematics. They knew fractions, decimals, and of course the four basic operations, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. These are the base of mathematics which a person starts from. And they also started calculating the area and volume of the geometrical figures like a rectangle, circle and cylinder. So they put their knowledge to in this picture you can see I have presented the signs of four basic operations, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, and also the volume of the geometrical figures. Like what are geometrical figures? I have shown like a rectangle, circle and cylinder. So with the help of this, they can major achievements in the field of medicine. We come to know that Egyptians had a good knowledge about the human body, that is they had a knowledge about human anatomy, that is the study of the body, human body. And one of the medical books was also there which had a good description. They had quite knowledge about the blood circulation in the body, and the Egyptians also preserved the mummies which were thousands. In this slide we'll come across the major achievements of the Egyptian in astronomy. The Egyptian actually studied the movement of the heavenly bodies like star, moon, sun, these all things were taken into consideration to predict anything. That is, to from beforehand only they used to predict something, that is what is going to happen. The natural phenomena means through their senses or what is going to occur. So they observed that the star Sirius, one star named Sirius was there, and that always appeared when annual flood in the river happened, means that event took place. So that annual flood was there in River Nile, and both of them coincides. So by this they can understand, like, whenever star Sirius is there, there is annual flood in the River Nile. So this by this they used to calculate the timings also. The Egyptians were the first to devise a solar calendar, means to design a solar calendar. In this slide we learn about the script of the Egyptian. The Egyptian system of writing is called hieroglyphics. It is called as hieroglyphics. Now that means sacred writing, which is related to religion. They also used pictures which represented words. Any words which they wanted to say, they used to draw the pictures related to them. And they also used to draw symbols to express their ideas. And they used to write from right to left. Like we people write from left to right. So they used to write from right to left. They also used. In this slide we can see a picture in which you can see the papyrus reeds. And these sheets, these reeds were used for making paper sheets, and a pointed reed was also used for pen. So here you can see this picture shows the hieroglyphic script, that is the pictures and the symbols which are used over here to express the ideas. They were written from right to. What is the meaning of decline? The meaning of decline is downfall. Now after the new kingdom came to an end, what happened after that? The Egyptian empire collapsed. Collapse means it fell down. And the rebellions means that the rebel was there. They were fighting amongst each other, and the foreign invasion was also there. Invasion means entering into one's territory without the permission of that person or forcefully. So that foreign invasion was also there. For that the empire weakened. This was the reason why the empire weakened, the internal rebellions and foreign invasion. So Egypt came to be conquered by the Assyrians, Persians and Romans. And so what happened, this civilization of Greece and Rome, they were greatly influenced by the Egyptian civilization. And students, you have to also go through more to know, that is where in blocks it is written, inside the blocks whatever is written you have to go through them. Question might come from there. And you should also know that cats were also tamed by the Egyptians to protect the food grains from mice. That's why it became very holy to people, and people started worshipping them. Cats not only had their own god, that is Bastet, but they were also preserved as mummies. And the mummified cats were left.